we just want to welcome people watching. Ariel is watching in Missouri.
She just got her new house too, didn't she?
She just got her new house.
Praise God.
And we have Dennis Lafayette and Kathy watching from the Tuolumne County. We welcome you guys. I see Melissa watching up there from Calaveras County and
awesome.
People from different areas. I just need my glasses to see the screen from the airport.
I
don't have, well, I guess.
You want to borrow mine?
Anyways, no, I'm good. I can read it. I can squint. I can.
I will. Wow.
But this is our first program, and I just want to share a little vision. When I first started getting exposed to ministry, one of the first ministries the Lord led me to was a Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship. And I remember I went to a meeting, I won't say how many years ago, it was over 20 years ago, up in Sonora, at the Sonora Inn.
Telling your age.
And this gentleman was a worship leader. This guy can sing, if you're watching. He can sing. He did an awesome job. And I met him over 25 years ago in Sonora. That's how we met. And anyways, long story short, the president of the Full Gospel Businessmen's chapter took me to various events. And one of the places he took me was to meet a guy named Chester Smith. And I got exposed to his television ministry. And he had a program called The 11th Hour.
I still remember that program.
And I just remember it made such an impact on me, and I was just a babe of the Lord. And they also took me to Channel 42. Ron House had a program.
Too.
And I got to go to some of those meetings. I actually got to go on television a few times way back. This is back in the 90s. And I just felt so blessed to be part of that way back when. And there was something about the 11th hour that just has stuck with me all these years. And what it was, it had a community aspect to it. It was reaching out to the community at local level, and it was really it was an awesome program. How many remember the 11th hour?
I still remember it. Yeah.
And
years ago.
And so the Lord's kind of given me a vision of doing something in the same spirit, and that's what our heart is here, is to reach people at the local level. And you know, thank God for the big national programs and all that, but you know, this is something that maybe I feel like the Lord has put it on my heart to create a platform where the Holy Spirit has freedom to do what He wants to do and express Himself with various individuals like Daniel and other people. And so that's part of my heart, is to create a platform for the Holy Spirit to do things. And I believe the Lord is wanting to build up community. He wants to bridge communities. He wants to bring unity. And I don't believe we have yet to discover the power of unity in the church, in the body. And God, not saying we all have to go to the same church, but God has a plan for this area. And this is a big deal. I was inspired by those programs way back when. And so that's my heart here. And so, for example, next week we're going to have some other gentlemen. We're going to have other ministries come from the Bay Area. I just want to announce this real quick. From San Francisco, Oakland. At the end of the month, they're going to do a campaign. Reach San Francisco is going to go for a whole week. And it's with SOS Ministry and another church group, and they're going to come this week and this next week. We're going to have them on and talk about what's going on in Reach San Francisco. And I feel like God's going to connect hearts. He's going to connect us. It's going to be something through various testimonies and things. We might even take our cameras out there And some of you may want to join us and go out into San Francisco. We're going to go out one day and take some cameras and just shoot a few clips. But I don't know what the format's going to be every week, but this is the heart of it. And so we're on in the Modesto area. We're on in the Motherlode communities. We're on in the Bay Area. And that's what this program's going to be about. So hope that blesses you. And if this is something that speaks to you, people watching, you know, just join in with us, support us with your prayers, you know, share this with your friends. And, you know, God's going to do something in this community. It's not about our church. It's about building unity, building up the body. And that's our heart. So just wanted to share some of the vision. Yeah. What do you think, Daniel?
I think you said a mouthful.
Okay, yeah.
But, yeah, it's been a long time, hasn't it?
Yeah.
25 years is quite a span of time, but I still remember those programs you're talking about, the 11th Hour.
Oh,
Chester
man.
Smith poured into a lot, an entire generation, and I think he was a forerunner.
He really
headed up a lot of dynamic changes in a lot of ministries. In fact, some of the ministries that have been birthed out of that are still going today, a lot of them. I think a lot of his sons and daughters in the spirit realm are still up functional and still doing the work of the same stuff that he did. He poured it all into them. So, and then, I mean, you talk about some of those other ministries too, from, I think, Ron House. I still remember Ron House from years ago. That was, he was also a forerunner of some of the things that are still going right now. So God has really raised up a heritage and an inheritance in those ministries. And I think that, and I know a lot of people are watching here. Some of them are, you're talking about going to San Francisco. I have a friend online right now, Cindy Shelton. She's back east, and she has a ministry on the streets doing something similar to what you're talking about.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of people out there doing a lot of this stuff, same work.
Yeah.
And but you know what? Whether it's back east in Arkansas or Louisiana or wherever, or whether it's in California, same spirit. God's revolutionizing some things in ministry, and I'm blessed to watch it. So it's a really neat thing he's doing in the midst of the camp of God's people.
It really is. I was kind of shaking in my boots in the beginning when people asked me to go on their little program. I couldn't even hardly talk to my wife back then. I was so shy.
I was bad.
And Daniel, I heard you were pretty shy too. Yeah.
That was bad.
But you know, I feel like the Lord, I had to face my giants. I feel like the Lord is calling a lot of people to rise up in this hour and overcome their giants, because we're going to take some territory, and we need to rise up and just step out, become burdened with what the Lord is burdened with. And he put his burden on me to do this, to try to link up with several television stations and bring all this together. I can't tell you how much fun we've had doing this, you know, a lot of warfare. But God makes a way, he really does. And I believe he's going to do something in this whole region, hallelujah. So.
Well, and you're talking about linking up with other ministries, and I think that has been one of the things that is a highlight, I'll call it, of the last at least five years now. Is that God has been highlighting the working together of a lot of ministries. And in the last year specifically, I'm seeing a lot of ministries come together like they never have in the past. And that I think is a big keynote to what God's doing in this hour right now. And it's so many ministries, in fact, I got one of them online right now, Teresa McCartney, she's out in Texas. I had an interview with her on Facebook, and some of what she's doing out there is just off the hook. I mean, she's ministering out on the streets, just like what you're talking about in San Francisco. She's doing that same work. Cindy Shelton's doing that work, and God is raising up all of these ministries, but they're coordinating with each other.
Yeah, there's a collaboration going on, and. I believe the Lord is going to draw people together, and there's going to be some awesome things that happen. Hallelujah. You know, so anyways, we're just getting started here, but one thing that we want to do is we want to just bring everybody watching into worship with us here. And our sister Regina Stemmler, right? She came and she's going to lead a song. And then we're going to jump into a little discussion here. And I think there's some prophetic stuff happening right now. Heavy prophetic things are happening right now on this planet. We're going to talk about it a little bit. You've been having some dreams and visions, and the Lord's been stirring me. And I believe it's going to encourage people watching. But let's just take a moment and invite our sister Regina up. And we welcome Regina. And I'm going to turn the camera so you guys can watch her do a song. This is one of your own songs, right?
This is, yes.
So here's an original.
And I'm so excited because with everybody watching, good evening. I want this to go out to everyone. I just want to encourage you guys watching and then you guys here with us tonight. Just, and as you know, how healing the Lord is, how healing God is. And this song is just one song. It's called Healing. I just named it Healing Part One. I think it's the first time I ever really realized how much He could heal me. And it's the 6 years in the making kind of a testimony song. I just wrote it recently, but there's 6 years of healing in that, and I'm just so happy too what Pastor Kevin just and Daniel were talking about, facing your giants. The Lord is just really squeezing things out of me to be able to finally go where I was not willing to go before, and in a lot of ways. I mean, even just small things, not like starting a big project, but even in the small things with people, being willing to like love them or being willing to have conversation or different things that, you know, God's talking to you about, facing your own giants and some things that are hard to face and you know that it's been there for years, but He's allowing you to be able to face them and without any fear anymore. And so that's just what's on my heart. That's what God's doing in me. So I just kind of wanted to just talk about healing and just, yeah, facing those giants. Don't need to, for me, I'm learning, I don't need to be afraid of giants. God is on my side, obviously. Obviously, it's so obvious. It says it in the Bible. God is on your side, always. So that's coming forth out of my life, but I just want to sing this song and worship. Just participate as well in just listening to the Lord. And I'm just going to sing the words. And amen, amen for healing. Thank you, God, for healing.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Who was blessed by that worship? Praise the Lord. And so we're so thankful that our people are joining us. And again, this format is, we're just yielding to the Spirit of the Lord. And my friend Daniel has been such a blessing to this ministry. And it's just amazing. And here is another example. God's calling people to step out in this hour. And just within a few months, his ministry is just exploding, right? Tell people what's happening real quickly, you know?
Well, a lot of the ones that are watching, they know this, but there is a lot of acceleration for those who are willing to hear his voice and move. And you know what? There's a lot more to it than just hearing his voice. Because if you hear him, that's great. But acting out in a place of obedience is, and you know, a lot of people online right now, they're watching this, they know this because they hear me say it so much. But hearing God is only part of the equation. Being willing to step out and be obedient to some of the most ridiculous things he would ask you to do is the other part. And a lot of people look at that and they go, well, I don't know if I want to do this. And some of the people online are like, yeah, I just did that. Got several people going, yeah, I stepped out on a limb. And then they found out that it wasn't a limb, it was fish line. Because you feel like you're walking on air and you're actually standing on something that's so invisible to the naked eye. And you go, Lord, am I really doing this? Am I really going to do this? And you get out there and you go, oh, I guess I can do this. And some people, you're kind of a living testimony of that. I mean, just recently you had the enemy tried to knock your entire thing out, stole all your camera equipment and everything. So there's challenges to everything that we do. And you know what? But I mean, praise God, he's got what?
Yeah, my little camera turned into that big thing right
now. He's got a big camera now. And I'm like, wow. So I mean, you know, what the enemy meant for evil.
you know, and I got a prophetic word from the Lord that a new camera was coming. I didn't know how it was going to come. I got robbed when I was preaching somewhere. And but it just seems like the enemy will try to stop the will and the plan of God. And he'll do it if you let him. But God's just looking for people to rise up and deal with the giants and take some territory.
Absolutely. And that's one of the things I think that's so amazing is that when people really get a hold of who they really are, and the dynamic of what God has called them to, and you really realize, I mean really realize, that God himself is behind you. Nothing will stop you.
Oh yeah.
Nothing will stop you. Because at that point, and I shared this the other night on one of the live streams, that the only real opinion that matters
is God.
Is his. His opinion is the only one that makes any difference in the world. And once a believer really gets a hold of that, you can't be stopped. You can't be stopped. And I think that there's so many people who they haven't quite got a hold of that. You can hear it here 1,000 times, but once it really hits your heart, something clicks. And you go,
oh, yeah.
Man, that's it. So you really realize that if God is for you, who can be against you? And I've probably read that passage 1,000 times before I finally understood that, you know what, he really is for me. No matter what else comes against, whether it's stolen equipment or whether it's a live stream that won't work, or whether or not I feel like I've had everything except the kitchen sink thrown at me before I hit that live button. Because so oftentimes, right before a major breakthrough, he'll throw everything and anything at you to stop you. And it's usually right on the verge of everything that God's getting ready to bust out of is when everything will come against you in a massive way. And this has been experience talking more than anything else, but also other people's testimonies. I mean, you get one like that too, I know.
Yeah.
So
Praise the Lord. Yeah, he makes a way where there is no way. You know, and I just totally agree with what he's saying. You know, when you get a revelation of who God is in your life and in your circumstances, it will change what you do. And usually you move according to your revelation of who he is. And when you have a revelation that God's with you, that he's calling you to go out, and if he is really with you, who can be against you? It'll turn you into a lion, you know? It'll turn you into...
That's what happened to me.
Yeah, look at this guy. So, and that's what I think the Lord is about to do in this hour. I believe he's about ready to take the lid off of everything, and it's going to open up. And I really believe that. And we've been teaming up a little bit. And
quite often,
especially up in Tuolumne County. And it's just interesting the things that the Lord is sharing with me, he's sharing with him. And it seems to be in agreement with things that the scripture has revealed too, what happened. And so, for example, I believe there's heavenly patterns starting to form right now. Heavenly patterns, indicating that we're about ready to enter into a season that the Lord spoke of when he was walking this planet. And Daniel just had some interesting visions here just this last week, and I've been having a few, but I feel, would you share your dreams that you had? And I'll share just a couple highlights.
Yeah. I put two of them on as posts earlier on in the week, but and I didn't go into great detail on them, but one of them was specifically, it was a dry, barren area, massively dry, barren area. Anybody ever seen what it looks like after a forest fire goes through and you see the region, what the region looks like? I mean, it looks just like a waste. I mean, everything is just burnt, charred, destroyed. And I just found myself standing in a place like this in this dream. I'm like, thinking to myself, where on earth did you drop me? I'm like, this is ridiculous. This place looks terrible. And then I hear thunder over my head. I'm just in time to look up, and I see thunder clouds gathering over my head. And all of a sudden, it starts to rain. Like some of the stuff some of my peeps in Texas have seen. Anybody ever been to Texas? You see what Texas rain looks like?
Oh, man.
Looks like a solid wall of water coming out of the sky. I had that experience last time I was there. That's what this was like in this dream. And I'm like, my Lord, what is going on here? But the rain literally began to reshape the entire landscape of everything that was laid waste. And under the surface, it began to wash all the dirt and the ash away. And under the surface of the ground, I began to see gold and silver veins appearing underneath the soil that was revealed by the water coming out of the sky. And as the water got heavier and thicker and the rain began to pour even harder, I began to see pools of water pooling up, and it became streams washing even more of the dirt away and revealing things that were hidden underneath this charred wasteland. And I said, God, what am I looking at? Why am I seeing this? And then he spoke to me in a dream, and he said, this wasteland is a representation of many of my people's lives. The physical elements have laid waste everything that they can see with the naked eye. Everything that was growth, that was green, that was fertile in their lives, it was burnt and charred by the circumstances that they faced. But what they don't know is that I have hidden gold, silver, and precious things in the soil of who they are. And when the rain comes, when the rain of his presence comes, when the former and the latter rain comes, when that heavenly washing of the water of the word comes, it begins to wash all the dirt and the soot and everything that was charred and laid waste by the circumstances of this life. It begins to wash all that away to reveal the gold, the silver and the precious things hidden in the lives of those people. So as I begin to watch all this dynamic take place, then of course right behind that, if anybody knows anything about what happens when a forest fire happens, all the seeds that are in the soil from the fire, when the rain hits, they start to germinate and brand new life comes up in places where there was desolation and just destruction. So God brings fresh life to bear and reveals everything hidden in the soil after that, all that devastation happens.
Isn't that?